It makes me feel expensive, like, you get what I mean? Like, it's just like an expensive song. Hello, it is Latrell, back with a brand new video, and I haven't posted once again in 2 weeks, and I said I was gonna come out with a video talking about explaining my absence and why I haven't been posting frequently on YouTube. I have to make the video. I obviously have to make the video. I can't leave you guys hanging. Even though it has no correlation to what I've been doing on this channel, the kind of videos I've been putting out, but it has to do with me and what I've been doing. With that being said, today we're gonna be reacting to Bree Runway's new mixtape, 2000AND4EVA. I have a video in the works just dedicated to Bree Runway, just going over how she's gonna be the next big thing, whether you like it or not, period. So when I first went to go look at Bree Runway and see what kind of music she has, because I found her from Brooke Candy, because she was she a writer? She was featured on Brooke Candy's debut album, Sexorcism, and Brooke uploaded videos of them in the studio, you know, turning up, whatever, dance to the music. And I'm like, oh, who's this girl, Bree Runway? Because Brooke tagged her. So I went to go see what kind of music she had. She had a song called What Do I Tell My Friends? I don't really remember it. I probably listened to it once. But that same year, she released an EP called Bree Runway, and I know some songs from there. She had a song, Big Racks, featuring Brooke Candy. I know you did that. Girl, make her rain like a money dance. And X2C and 2 On, like, she went off with Bree Runway. And I love the artwork, too. It was like, she's, like, half white. It's cute. Since then, she's been getting more relevant and, you know, working on her craft, working on new music. And she put out a song called Ape Shit. She just kept going viral on Twitter. That's one thing that I was paying attention to during the rise of Bree Runway, is that she just kept getting viral tweets. Like, she's gonna be the next Twitter sensation, the next artist that, you know, all the Twitter gays are gonna be flocking to. Then, I don't know, she released the song Gucci featuring Malibu Mitch. Now, Malibu Mitch, one of my favorite rappers. We love Malibu Mitch. She's just fucking, her flow, her sound, everything's amazing. Gucci, like, that's a hit that sticks like grits. Gucci like a girl, they can go. And it's on this EP too, mixtape, whatever. So when that comes on, whew, get ready. And then she released Little Nokia and the video for that. And Justin, you got Kylie Madonna, got Justin. She just dropped single there. Just, you know, dip her little feet in the water, see what people want, see what people like from her. And bitch, all of a sudden she's like, I'm releasing a tape. And what about it? So here we are today. If you've been watching my videos from some time, you know what I'm about to do. I'll snap my fingers and I'll be right back. I'm back. Okay. Oof, I'm buzzed. Oh. Can we also talk about fucking the excess remix, Rina Sawayama and Bree Runway? That was excess. Yes, I need more and more. Give me the big sprinkler bag into your couture. Give me just a little bit, a little bit excess. I mean, excess remix, a reset. Oh my god, my feet are fucking frozen. But it's like a nice day out today. Alexa, what's the temperature?
Right now, It's 13 degrees Celsius. Tonight, expect a low of 9 degrees.
That was fucking loud. Well, okay, we're not asking.
I'd rather not answer that.
Track number one is Ape Shit. Ape Shit, that's gonna be Runway 5. Bree 5. I only listened to that a handful of times because I didn't remember how many times it switched up like that. And was it the verse that was close to the final? It almost sounded like Missy Elliott, and I know Missy Elliott on this. Yeah, she's on track number 3. I can see that. Oof. Not ready for that. Ape Shit, that's gonna be 5. She's just so. She got them guitars up in there, like, just Bree Runway, just the queen of hyperpop, the queen of just doing everything. She's not a rapper, she's a superstar. Track number 2 is Little Nokia, and I've heard this a million times, so
put a good lit. I don't like
Little Nokia.
I heard my back.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Justin.
Yeah, Kylie Madonna got Justin. does Elena Nokia mean? What does she mean by that? So that's getting a 5. Period. I love Little Nokia. I thought Rico Nasty was supposed to be on it.
Rico!
Oh, it's at the bottom. She put both. Track number 3 is ATM Now. I just read one of her tweets this morning. Well, she's in like the afternoon in the morning because she's in England. I'm in Canada, but whatever. She tweeted, my friends from high school calling me, congratulating me, and like talking about that. She has a song with the Missy Elliott. Like, can you imagine that? Like, she's so young and like new in her career, and she has a song with Missy Elliott. Like, who? Where did you get that? She just came out and got one of the hip hop legends. Like, I'll take her.
ATM. But I know he really only want my vagina.
Oh.
Swipe, that's my language. Only rock with any nigga that can handle it. Shoes, top, skirt, blink, purse, or designer. Tough bitch, but my ass up. And I stay on his mind like a toothpaste. I don't need to worry about getting too deep. ATM. My type of boo, them Jamaican dudes. I'm like, yeah, come here, girl, let me show you a move so I can boom, boom.
Drill, you can see me, sir. ATM. A 5. ATM. Whip my hair. I don't have. Oh, I just shook my brain so much. Okay. ATM getting a 5. Period. Period dot. Oh, it's crazy how, like, she just came into the game. Like, she's not even, like, big. That's the thing. She doesn't have, like, the mainstream clout. Like, the way, like, the Megan Thee Stallion, the Saweetie's, the fucking, I don't even know, the other female hip-hop artists. Like, she's not even in that, like, universe. And she got a hip-hop icon to fucking collaborate with her on a song. That is crazy. Now, we're moving on. Track number 4 is Damn Daniel featuring, or with, Young Baby Tate. I've only listened to this once. I don't know why I never like revisited it.
That's why I get my T's out when I'm with the scarlet. See this, better say that shit. Better watch your back. Get say that shit.
Better watch your back.
What's up? It's Felicia.
I love Tate.
I just let him fall like Humpty Dumpty. It's been a while since I gave it a try. Cause I didn't leave him hot and dry. Until I met
the part where she's like, don't trust a man, he'll fuck all your friends. Ain't she spill. Never happened to me, but I just know there's a possibility. Okay, we're gonna give that a 5. Like, Bree, Runway, like, everything she's putting out here, like, these are all 5s. Like, I don't think she knows how to do anything less. Like, my standard that I have for her being a 5, like, all these songs are hitting the fucking mark. So, girl, go off. Next song is track number 5, and it is Rolls Royce.
No table full of rich niggas. We pull up, we get a table, we them rich niggas. White hell, ancient hell, bad as hell, yeah. Bad as hell, bad as hell, like to, yeah. Could show you how it's like a rich nigga.
My sister's playing music and now my vibe is ruined. I fucking hate her. Oh my god! I'm filming a video and she's playing music. Like, okay. Rolls Royce, we are giving that a 5. Rolls. Girl, she did that. I'm not saying because I don't want to get fucking, I can't get demonetized, but like, if these videos ever do get monetized in the future, when I get up there, I don't want them to get flagged, so I'm not gonna say it myself. She gave Nikki. Next song is track number 6, Gucci, featuring none other than the queen herself, the princess herself. Meh. Malibu Red, Gucci with the Malibu.
Let's go. Hey, hey.
Gucci like a girl they could call. Got a lot of nice things I need to know. You can call your friends, we can ball. Last night I was shaking my ass in the Marriott. Tonight we're doing business. I'm what you got.
I need Gucci, Fendi, Prada, tell him to holler. I got a different design. Burberry, baby shirt, Burberry, flip the daddy, grabbing on my fatty. And I'm hemmed up with a daddy. We can call him Big Maddie. I'm with a pussy, making daddy singing like Kid Deacon. I like bitches that in with the beef, if I'm with a vegan.
My crew, my girl, levels, break on, get to, hip to, I should take these plus the floor. The flower, the bitch, the flower, the bitch.
Ooh, song is like the biggest vibe. It can be God. Let me tell you, that was like one of my most played quarantine songs. It just goes the fuck off. Like, you get what I mean? I hate music playing. I feel like one of those fucking videos.
I like bitches that ain't with the beef as long as they're vegan.
Hey, she fucking ate that up. Anyways, it makes me feel expensive. Like, you get what I mean? Like, it's just like an expensive song. Next song is track number 7 and it's called For Nicole Thea and Baby Rain. Who are these people? Wonderful Thea and Baby Rain, what I've... Yeah, I knew it. It was someone who passed away. I remember seeing it on social media, Nicole Thea, and her baby died. That's so heartbreaking. Just because, oh my god. So, weren't they a YouTube couple? What a stupid ass fucking music playing. Oh my god, I'm gonna go crazy. Okay, next song is called No Sir, and it's a freestyle. So, let's get into it.
What the hell am I even gonna talk about?
Boy,
ain't hustling like you told them niggas like the Upsons.
Oh. No, that went off. No. This one went off. This is my favorite song on the album. I'm calling it now. This is my favorite song after Gucci. Sorry, I put on fucking lip balm like a crackhead. As people say to me, I think it's normal, but people laugh at me every time I put it on. I just put on, look, I just. I'm gonna. Anyways. What are we doing? No, sir, that's getting a 5. Period. Now, track number 9 is Little Nokia featuring Rico Nasty. Now, this song is literally meant for Rico. Like, when I first heard it, like, I'm like, why is Rico not on this? Like, this is meant for her. This is what she's doing. So, and Bree and Rico, they kind of have a similar thing going on. You know, they're the black girls that, like, you know, that. Okay. So, this could be a reset. This remix I'm about to hear right now. So, let's get into it. Track number 9, Little Nokia featuring Rico Nasty, the remix.
This nigga been calling my phone.
Rico.
Whenever I pop out,
Pepe 5. I give Little Nokia 5. Why am I not gonna give the added edition of Rico Nasty a 5 as well? It just makes sense. Oh, fuck, man. That was a mixtape, bitch. Oh my god, my hair's probably not all of it. Oh. Okay. Miss Bree, you, that was just 10s, babe. That was just 5s. That was a 5-star. That was a 5-star mixtape. That was a 5-fucking-star mixtape. Because, you know what? I fucking said so. Bree, you are killing the game. My video on you will be coming soon. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you want to keep up with me elsewhere, follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Gunshot with an A-W instead of an O. Please like this video. We're almost, I think we're like one away from like 700 subscribers. If I haven't made it by the time this video came up, I just want to say thank y'all for subbing. Thank you so much. We're only growing. So subscribe, please. We're gonna get into the algorithm. Yes, that's it. Deuces. Did I turn it off? Okay. Yep, rerun my, I love you.